Hi, good morning. The two authors were unable to arrive at the scene due to visa issues, and I'll be presenting their paper, Conditional Expectation Propagation, on behalf of them. And for any questions, please email the authors. That's what I was supposed to tell you all. So we'll start. As we all know, the central task in Bayesian inference is the evaluation of the posterior distribution, which can be computed using Bayes theorem. And in the formula, each factor fi can be a likelihood function or a prior distribution, and z is the normalization constant. But for many models of practical interest, the exact computation of the normalization constant can be infeasible due to complicated factors in high-dimensional space. In such situations, we should resort to approximation schemes. Expectation propagation is a widely used approximate inference algorithm, and it uses exponential family to approximate the true posterior distribution. Expectation propagation refines each approximate factor in an iterative way. Each time, after picking one approximate factor, tilde fi, by excluding it from the current approximation, we can get calibrating distribution q naught I, and q naught I is assumed already a good approximation to the other factors. Next, by multiplying the two factor with the calibrating distribution, we can get the tilted distribution. Then we get the optimal approximation by minimizing the KL divergence from the tilted distribution to the approximate distribution and update the factor by removing the calibrating distribution from the optimal approximation. After this, we just switch to another factor and repeat all these procedures until convergence. In fact, these procedures can be summarized in three basic steps: message deletion, projection, and update. Projection is the most important step, which is fulfilled by moment matching. Because the approximation is a member of exponential family, there is a well-known conclusion that the minimization of KL divergence is equivalent to matching the expected value of sufficient statistics between the approximate distribution and the true distribution. It is also called moment matching because the expectation can always be identified by the moment of the distribution. Unfortunately, the moments can sometimes be intractable because of the complicated tilted distribution. Here's a simple example of matrix decomposition. The first Gaussian factor is the typical likelihood function for matrix decomposition. The second Gaussian is the calibrating distribution. Theta 1 and theta 2 are latent factors, and xn is the element value. Given sufficient statistics, it is because the production of the two random variables that the computation of the normalization constant and the moment is intractable. In order to conduct expectation propagation algorithm, when the moments are intractable, there are several solutions. The first one is to handcraft an approximation to the moment and do the moment matching. However, this approach is non-trivial, and usually the approximation cannot be generalized to other forms of factors. The second solution is using Laplace approximation to approximate the tilted distribution and then do the moment matching. But it needs to run numerical optimization algorithms to find the location of the node, and it can be very expensive. The third one is important sampling based expectation propagation, which uses empirical methods to do moment matching. The last one is using learning methods to directly predict the factor to update. Both of the last two methods use important sampling, so they are time consuming and the accuracy can be unstable. For the last method, extra work needs to be done, such as feature extraction and a model design. So in their model of the authors, they were inspired by the Gibbs sampling, which generates samples from the distribution of each variable conditional on current values of the other variables. And we find that even if the joint distribution is complicated, the conditional distribution can have a much simpler form. Again, in this example, the joint distribution is complicated, but the conditional distribution of theta 1 given theta 2 or theta 2 given theta 1 is just a Gaussian distribution. So we wonder if we can address the interactable moments by incorporating conditional moments. In order to utilize the conditional moments, we first partition the random variables into m groups and factorize each factor over these groups. Then, according to the multiplication rule of probability, the tilted distribution can be represented as the product of marginal distribution and conditional distribution. Theta naught m represents the random variables excluding theta m. And the moment calculation can be represented in the form of nested expectations. The inner product expectation conditional moment can also be treated as the function of phi m. Phi m stands for all the sufficient statistics excluding phi theta m. Usually the conditional moment can have an analytical form. Even if it is interactable, we can fully factorize approximation and use quadrature formulas to do the computation. Alpha j is node weight and function g is the node value. The fully factorized approximation is frequently used in many algorithms. After getting the conditional moment, we can recover the moment of standard expectation propagation by taking the expectation with respect to the tilted marginal distribution. Due to the complicated factor in the distribution, the computation can be interactable. But we find that stationary points of EP, the expected value of Vm should also be matched between the tilted marginal distribution and the approximate marginal distribution. So we further assume the approximate marginal distribution as a good surrogate for the tilted marginal distribution. Now you may ask that the change of the distribution may end up with different stationary points. Yes, indeed, but under certain circumstances, the stationary points of the EP and CEP are the same. That's when the conditional moments are a subset of Vm, which stands for all the sufficient statistics excluding phi theta m. The last step is optional because even if we change the distribution of the expectation, the calculation can still be interactable. In such situations, we return to the conditional moment and use Taylor approximation to estimate it. In this way, after taking the expectation, we can formulate the approximate moment in an analytical way. So far, we don't use any numerical optimization algorithms or sampling methods. What we need to do is just deriving the second order derivatives. Now, in conditional expectation propagation, we use factorized approximation to approximate the true posterior distribution. At each iteration, after message deletion, we first compute the conditional moment, then calculate the expected value. If it's tractable, we just do the moment matching and update factor. Otherwise, we do the Taylor approximation and then this process is repeated until convergence. To examine the quality of our algorithm, we first tested it for two classical models, Bayesian logistic regression and Probit regression, on two simulated data sets. CEP1 uses first-order Taylor approximation, and CEP2 uses second-order Taylor approximation, and we compared our algorithms with standard expectation propagation, Laplace propagation, which is called LP, important sampling-based expected propagation called IS, and kernel-based just-in-time learning method called KJIT. As we can see, CEP1 and CEP2 always end up with similar approximate KL divergences with standard EP and are faster than the other methods. The performance of IS and KJIT are extremely bad even if we use the sample sizes of 0.5 million. It may be because of the unstable accuracy of sampling methods. We also tested on 6 real data sets. As we can see, CEP can always achieve a close performance to standard EP and can be much faster than the other methods. Then we tested our method for Bayesian tensor decomposition, where the exact moment is interactable. VMP stands for variational message passing, and CPWOP uses the gradient optimization to do tensor decomposition. A log is a continuous tensor, and Enron is a binary tensor. As we can see, our method CEP outperforms the other methods and the running time per iteration is much faster than Laplace propagation. Finally, in order to handle large-scale tensor data, we tested our method for streaming tensor decomposition and adapted CEP into assumed density filtering framework. We compared with the state-of-the-art streaming tensor decomposition method, POST, and static tensor decomposition method, CPWOP, and CEP consistently outperforms the other methods on 5 different batch sizes. So far, we can conclude that conditional expectation propagation can handle interactable moments and achieve a similar performance with standard expectation propagation by conducting efficient and analytical updates without the need for handcrafted approximations, expensive sampling, or numerical optimizations. Thank you.